Another day, another episode of What's Up Mainframe. We're kind of continuing in a streak of discussing kind of communities around our products and solutions. And one of the central products in DevOps for us is Endevor. So I'm really happy to have the product owner for Endevor and some other solutions around it today, Vaclav Brunnhofer, as we call him here in the office. Welcome.
Nice pronunciation. Yeah, I'm happy to be here.
I got it right. So Endevor has this incredible community, and there are so many avenues to really reach out and meet other people working on Endevor and obviously talk to those of us in Broadcom. So let's start with something that happened recently and one avenue to kind of find out what's really new with Endevor, and those are the validation calls. So can you walk us through what happens during the validation calls?
Absolutely. Yeah, so first, Endevor has a great customer community that we meet with regularly. And one of the opportunities is attending our validation call. I would highly suggest to every Endevor user or customer to consider to register and go to the validation calls, because the main benefit for Endevor users and Endevor customers is to directly influence our work in progress. Yeah. So what we mostly try to present on the validation calls is what we are currently working on. And so we get direct feedback from customers on what, if we are going in the wrong direction or if they like what they see. We also have polls. So we ask if they're not feeling comfortable to speak on the call, they can answer the questions, and we absolutely consider those their answers and their feedback, and we take that direction if we think it's what the customers want.
Yeah, no, and it's of so much benefit for us to get quicker feedback. Yeah. So that we can really reprioritize if we need to. And I like how you emphasize, the need for anyone touching Endevor to really register for these. Because I my feeling is that with the validation calls, we have a lot of Endevor admins who, of course, have a lot of experience and a lot of knowledge. But if you're a dev and you're working with Endevor or one of the clients of Endevor Web Services, we want your feedback as well. And this is exactly the forum where you can.
Yeah, absolutely. It's 90 minutes every 2 months. And you will learn about what we plan to work on. You will learn what's already available, maybe, and you don't know about it. Yep. Or you can express your feedback on what you see and if there's something we should adjust. Yeah, absolutely.
So that's one place. And the means of getting there is registering in our Validate site specifically. And then you'll get the invites, which will come directly from this guy. And so you can always email him too if you need that. So perfect.
Absolutely, no problem.
Now that's kind of a smaller scope, but we started with that because that happened recently. So that's one aspect. So tell us a little bit about the broader Endevor community. And we obviously have this community's website. So what kind of things happen at that level?
Yeah, so one thing I would really like to mention is that we have this ideation section.
Okay.
Where every customer, every Endevor user can create an ideation request. And we regularly go through them, we review them. And even with customers, we have regular community calls. Mm-hmm. I believe it's quarterly, where we go through all of the ideations that have been created over the course of the last three months. And we also review them with our product manager. Mm-hmm. And customers mostly can vote on them. So we try to continuously work on the top three, let's say, with the most votes. So it's really worth going there, checking what even other customers or other users have created and add votes.
And it's certainly kind of an avenue too for people to understand how other customers are using Endevor, because through their requests you can say, that's an aspect of a workflow that we're considering, or we had shelved and now we see that the community is actually voting for it. And as I understand it too, the way the voting goes on and then the prioritization that you do is the top three things get pulled into the backlog, and then some timeline around their delivery gets shared with everyone in that community.
Exactly. As you said, that they can see how other customers use Endevor. It's good and bad because, it sometimes outside my even imagination what customizations they made over the years.
But you hit on an important point, though, is that as much as it is for kind of pushing their agenda, what they want, it's a place where people can learn, and it really becomes a forum then, because people can respond and add additional comments, which is kind of the broader goal of that community site. So ideation is one aspect of it, but otherwise, folks are posting questions, problems,
yes,
strange customizations.
Yeah. What I really like about it, it's actually not, we don't have to kind of be part of those conversations. So it's their conversations, their discussions, which are basically placed on our community site. Mm-hmm. So we have a direct access to them, and we can really watch what's going on. And they talk to each other, which is something which is really great about the Endevor community. They function on their own. So
definitely,
not required. We can step in, but it's not required. And
Yeah, no, certainly. We provide the platform and they lead the discussions.
Exactly.
And then if there are work items, they may come to us or not. So we have the validation community, which is kind of more formal registration. The Broadcom communities, which does require some registration, but otherwise it's really an open forum. It has this ideation. And then we get to meet a lot of the Endevor folks in person, don't we?
Yeah, absolutely. There's a long history of Endevor user group events.
Okay.
That's, that kind of where the communities from all around the world meet, mm-hmm, in obviously in different places at different times. But yeah, we get to meet our customers on these events, and it's definitely a great experience.
Certainly, and it's, again, like the communities forum, it's very much where it's almost like, yes, we're working on Endevor, but they all want to talk to each other. They want to hear a little bit from us, but it's more about them driving what they're doing with Endevor.
Yeah, they don't only talk, they're like, I think the events are fun. You've been to multiple,
yes,
of those yourself. So it's really fun, and it's great because they like to meet, because mostly it's yearly. So they like to meet each other as well, not only us, but we help to organize these events. So we're part of it. And I think it's fun. And at the same time, we learn a lot of things. We get a lot of feedback, positive and negative. So
yeah,
but it helps us.
It's certainly it's a really vibrant community in that sense. Now, how did you come into the Endevor world? Tell us a little bit about yourself and how you came to be the product owner of Endevor.
So I joined Broadcom or CA back then, 2011. I worked for 8 years in the mainframe application tuner team. Mm-hmm. I was product owner then for a very short period of time. And then I was offered to become an Endevor product owner, which was exciting and scary.
Daunting.
And I was warned by multiple people. It's very exposed. It's really a lot of conversations to customers. It's a very complex product, very customized all around the world, a very challenging. But I don't regret it at all. It's been a great experience. And I actually love working on the product, which is so much exposed and so much used by so many customers.
That we have all these interactions with.
Absolutely.
Although I imagine in the beginning that was really scary when people, you know that guy. Not yet.
Yeah. The scariest part is that so many people that know it much more than you do. And it's still the case, because a lot of our customers, and I would say almost friends at the moment, I would say colleagues, they've been using Endevor for decades. So obviously they know more than you, and that's scary, but it's also challenging, and it gets you to learn the stuff, really.
Definitely. Now, we can't talk about community and connecting with these people without mentioning something which is coming up soon. And so if you haven't already registered, we highly recommend that you go and look up our Mainframe Technical Exchange. We'll be having an in-person event here in Prague at the end of March. So please register. You can come see us, come see Lukasz behind the camera. He'll be there as well. And then later in the year, there'll be another version of the Mainframe Technical Exchange in Plano in September. So check out Mainframe Technical Exchange. Come talk to some Endevor experts. Come talk to Vasek and myself, and learn more from other customers actually about our products, because we get great value from it and we think you will as well. So Vasek, thanks for talking us through the Endevor community,
thanks for having me.
All the avenues, and
thanks for having me.
Perfect.